Hi, my name is Anne Warda. I am the executive director of Burpee Museum, and for the last several years, we have been facing some interesting times. Between the COVID shutdown and the flood we faced in 2021, we're heading into 2022 with some of the best and most integral staff members that we really could not have done without.
So in the spring, we actually had a huge flood, which caused a lot of damage throughout our front of our museum and actually to our collections, our education department, and our staff came together and we were able to clean up the flood and open up these brand new exhibits, even open up a temporary exhibit that focuses around East Africa to bring in new tours and new kids that have never seen the museum before.
This past summer was the first time we've been back into the field since the pandemic, and it was fantastic. People were itching to get out in the field, you know, to get out west, walk around the Badlands, look for fossils coming out, and excavate. And most of our volunteers felt the same way. To get back out, to see everybody again, to get back to our routine of getting these dinosaur bones out was amazing. We had a super successful season, hundreds of bones coming out like we do every year, so everybody got to work on bones. We had new people coming in. We got a lot of prospecting. We found, I think, 16 new dinosaur sites, including one new Triceratops skull coming out. Summer of 2022 should be really, really successful in both Utah and Montana, and we're super excited to get back out there.
Next year, we're going to be offering more to our community than we ever have before. We're working to align our tours to be able to better help out our teachers and our community to meet those standards when they come here to Burpee. We're going to have new exhibits and we're going to reimagine more than we have before.
Unfortunately, this past spring we had another flood here at the Burpee Museum, which was kind of devastating to the museum for a short period of time. However, it allowed us to reassess our entire collections in the basement. So we've gone through, we've handled every specimen that probably hasn't been done in 75 years, and we got to figure out exactly what we have in our collections and begin reorganizing the whole thing.
So once we opened up our new exhibits, everyone was very excited to see what we had that was brand new. They've been waiting forever for these exhibits, it felt like. They were very pleased. Right once you walk in, they see the brand new branding on the Columbian mammoth, and then they also look up and see a Smilodon crouching over, ready to attack a giant beaver, and then they look to the left and there's something new. They look behind them, there's something new. It's so engaging, and we're so excited to share it with everyone.
One of the biggest goals for this year will be to renovate the labs.
Our biology lab is in need of renovation, including updated equipment, safety standards, and more space to work. Most importantly, we're excited to add windows that open, just like the paleo lab, so they can speak with scientists while they're working.
We work on dinosaurs from the Morrison Formation, sauropod dinosaurs, huge animals, 70, 80 feet long. The bones are large. The lab is nice, but it's not as big as it should be. So our goal for the next coming year is to remove the offices that are in the lab right now and open that whole space up so we can get more volunteers to come in, a bigger space, to work on larger animals. So that's one of the primary goals.
In the future, we're going to be creating new programming that reaches new age groups. So we want to target some of our younger scientists and be able to implement more play-based learning where they get to explore the natural world and understand the scientific properties at their level. And we do also want to engage more of our older audiences as well, since that's a program that we haven't been able to do as much in the past.
So since the creation of these new exhibits that we were able to install over COVID, it has definitely drawn new interest. Just for new people coming into the museum, it's been cool to see in the exhibits in general. However, for people who've been with Burpee for the last 10, 15 plus years, to come in after COVID and see essentially a new museum. You walk in the door and there's a new lobby. You go on the second floor and then the second floor is entirely new exhibits, a new geology exhibit and a new Pleistocene Ice Age exhibit, which is cool because it kind of fills in a gap that we haven't had previously.
Burpee means so much to not only me, but the community. We have, I feel like, risen from the ashes within this pandemic and then the flood, and we really don't know what's going to happen for the future, but we keep going. We keep striving for great things. We're going to open up great exhibits. We're starting new classes. We have a great interactive and engaging community.
This group of individuals will stop at nothing for this museum, and despite the challenges that we've faced, we literally are in a better place than we were a year ago from
today. And we're standing on the precipice with more hope than ever. Thank you for your support, your guidance, and most of all, your innovation.